Traveling as Kenya's president is not just a logistical challenge. It is a grand spectacle of opulence and security, with a price tag exceeding 7.05 billion shillings. President Ruto's journey showcased the intersection of luxury and protection. In the bustling streets of Nairobi, where the economy teeters on the brink, sightings of President Ruto are rare, unless there is a pressing matter at hand. Navigating through the city's chaotic traffic and bustling crowds poses significant risks, prompting the presidential security detail to carve out a private route from the State House to the CBD. This exclusive road, closed off to all but the president, becomes the stage for an impressive procession whenever President Ruto ventures out. Accompanied by a convoy of dozens of vehicles and a formidable police escort, his motorcade is a sight to behold, unlike any other in Africa. It boasts a fleet of at least 20 vehicles, including 5 armored cruisers manned by the elite officers from the Reke squad, armed with an arsenal ranging from sniper rifles to anti-tank grenade launchers. They ensure the president's safety at all costs. An ambulance with the medical personnel follows closely, prepared for any eventuality also. Now, President Ruto's travels are not just journeys. They are a demonstration of power, prestige, and unwavering security measures. In the event of an attack, the primary team's responsibility is neutralizing the threat, while the second team ensures the safe evacuation of the president. At the heart of this operation lies the armored Mercedes-Benz S560, valued at 27 million Kenyan shillings. This vehicle epitomizes both luxury and security. Now, during last year's Jamhuri Day celebrations on December 12, 2023, President Ruto opted for this black Mercedes-Benz S560 over the traditional presidential limousine. Designed as a mobile fortress, it boasts features such as a 9G Tronic 9-speed automatic transmission and an all-wheel drive system. With a top speed of approximately 260 km per hour and an acceleration from 0 to 100 km per hour in 4.6 seconds, it combines performance with efficiency, achieving fuel consumption rates of around 7.65 km per liter in the city, 11.47 km per liter on the highway, and 8.87 km per liter combined. Now, customized to ensure President Ruto's safety, the vehicle is heavily armored to withstand various threats, including bullet fires, landmine explosions, chemical attacks, and even small-scale missile strikes. Transforming this fortified vehicle into a comfortable command center for President Ruto, its interior features luxurious leather seating, polished finishes, and advanced communication equipment. Now, the Aura Center enhances its functionality, serving as a mobile command hub. More than just a symbol of luxury, Ruto's Mercedes-Benz represents his unwavering authority and determination to prioritize his protection above all else. When President Ruto ventures beyond Nairobi, particularly into arid areas, his security detail faces a heightened challenge. His personal security meticulously plans the safest route and modes of transportation. Days prior, police and special forces begin preparations, intensifying vigilance and swiftly quelling any hint of protests. To bolster security, officers are strategically placed in various locations such as pubs and gathering spots for surveillance. On the day of Ruto's visit, security measures are stringent, with snipers positioned on rooftops ready to neutralize any threat to the president's safety. Now, plainclothes officers blend into the crowd, especially among those welcoming Ruto, ensuring a vigilant presence. Spontaneous interactions with the president are rare, typically limited to orchestrated encounters with party activists or undercover law enforcement. One memorable incident involved President Ruto and his deputy Rigathi Gachagua being taken a video enjoying roasted maize at a public event. Now, in the video, it appeared to be an ordinary scene, a market bustling with vendors selling their goods. Yet, there was more than meets the eye. Among them was a maize seller who, unbeknownst to many, was actually an officer in disguise. As observers glanced over, they noted the peculiar manner in which the president approached different vendors. Now, the man vending sugarcane seemed unkempt, despite Ruto holding a packet of the goods he was selling, which were sugarcane actually. The canes did not touch the president's lips. He took the packet, stared at it, and returned it. Moving on, the president encountered a maize vendor whose appearance and posture contrasted starkly with the first. Shaved hair, no beards, and well-spoken, without hesitation, the president grabs a maize from the vendor and he starts eating. He then moves to the next vendor, who happens to be an old woman. He interacts with her, and that's all. Surprisingly, the president doesn't eat any other foodstuff from any other vendors apart from the maize seller. Now, this maize seller was the odd one out from the other vendors. His appearance and posture resembled an officer, as it is known that none of President Ruto's security officers have beards or long hair. This particular one had no hair, no beards, while other vendors had beards and long hair. Of course, such stunts aren't strictly unique to Kenya's president. Most world leaders script their visits so they can be sheltered from any danger. When President Ruto decides to travel outside the country, he prioritizes traveling in utmost style and luxury, evident in his preference for the lavishly adorned Fokker 70 aircraft. Now, despite owning private jets, presidential protocol dictates that international trips require scrutiny by experts for safety, leading him to opt for the Fokker 70. Accompanied by his own security detail, President Ruto utilizes the Fokker 70, a relic from former President Daniel Moi's era, for his overseas travels. For those interested in leasing a similar aircraft, rate starts at approximately 1.3 million Kenyan shillings per hour, as reported by Paramount Business Jets. Now, this customized jet boasts a capacity of 26 passengers in contrast to the standard private charter's 70 seats, making it ideal for VIP clientele due to its exclusivity and costs. Lastly, featuring an array of amenities including an entourage lounge, VIP dining area, VIP lounge, VIP bedroom, private office, surround system, LCD televisions, satellite communications, and high-speed internet, the Focus 70 epitomizes luxury air travels.